Our next speaker ranks among the 40 biggest hit makers of the entire rock era. This is based on the Billboard Hot 100 Pop Singles charts. Our day's guest ranks second behind only Aretha Franklin as the most charted female vocalist of all time, with 56 singles making the Billboard Hot 100. She has been nominated for 7 Grammys, and she has won 5. Let's welcome Dionne Warwick.
Thank you. Well, good afternoon. I am so sorry that I'm taking everything out of kilter up here. But originally, I wasn't supposed to be here. And it was only because I was supposed to be in Austria right this moment. And I will be leaving here shortly, getting on a plane to be in Austria at this moment. And because I was not going to be here, I did send an email to be read. So instead of having it read, I'm going to read it. My dear friend, unfortunately, I am unable to be with you for this much-deserved honor. Please know I am with you in spirit and am applauding the loudest with a very, very loud yell of happiness for you. When you walk up to receive your honor, continue to take good care of you. I want you to know I met this man back in 1958 at a theater in Brooklyn, New York, called the Brooklyn Fox Theater. And I, along with the Shirelles and so many other acts in the industry at the time, were on a Christmas show, Mary the K, Christmas Extravaganza, starring Johnny Mathis. And all the ladies, including me, could not wait to just look at him. I mean, everybody just wanted to look at him. You know, it's very, very seldom you'll find men that qualify as actually being called pretty. Handsome is usually the vernacular used. Johnny Mathis was pretty. And we all made our way to the side of the stage every single night, 5 shows a day. Just to look at him. We all knew he could sing, but we wanted to look at him. We looked at you a lot. I had the immense pleasure of touring with this wonderful, wonderful human being. And as Deniece said, he is probably one of the most loving and giving and caring human beings that anyone could ever get to know. He was so kind to me. I will never, ever forget my experience with Johnny Mathis, and I certainly hope that you don't either. I'm getting ready to do a new project, and I just badgered him into being a part of it. So you will be hearing us sing together again. Mr. Mathis, I love you. Thank you.
Our next day's guest has been heralded as a singer's singer. She began her professional career at age 17 and quickly made her mark with Stevie Wonder's band Wonderlove. Let's hear it for Stevie. Her 4-octave range has thrilled listeners all over the world. She has sung songs that range from ballads to gospel standards. In 1978, she and Johnny Mathis recorded the song Too Much, Too Little, Too Late, which shot up to number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 chart. In 1984, she recorded and released the album Let's Hear It for the Boy, in which the title track reached number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100 chart and was featured on the soundtrack of the movie Footloose. This incredible singer has been nominated for 12 Grammys and has won three. She's still performing, and we are thrilled to have her with us this afternoon. Put your hands together for Deniece Williams.
Hello. I tell you, you know, it's just been such an awesome, awesome pleasure and an honor to know Johnny and have been around him. That's my baby, you know. That's my baby. Don't get any ideas, ladies. That's my baby. I remember when I was a little girl, well, teenager, I would say, I was already in dress rehearsals with Johnny because he would be on Mike Douglas or one of the television shows, and I'd be singing, standing up there singing harmony with him. I didn't know I was practicing for the big moment, but I was, because I just loved his voice, and I loved the way it felt in my spirit and in my heart, and he was my singer's singer, so I was just fooling around, and my mom would come in and laugh at me, and I said, oh, that's, you know, you got to practice with the best. And she loved him. My mom was such a great fan of Johnny. And years later, when I got my own recording contract and got an opportunity to sing, I got a call from my manager. And he said, Johnny Mathis is considering doing a duet. Would you love to sing with Johnny Mathis? I asked him if he was crazy. Who doesn't want to sing with Johnny Mathis and all that lusciousness, okay? So it did happen, and I never forget, I went and I told my mother, Mom, I'm going to be doing a duet with Johnny. I had to fan my mother. She tried to faint and fall out and wanted to know when we were going in the studio. I said, we're not going nowhere, because I know you. I introduced you to Marvin Gaye, and I saw what happened. I'm not introducing you to Johnny Mathis. No way. So I was so excited to sing with him, but of course I had only had my second project out, and I was thinking, I'm getting ready to sing with the legend. I don't believe this is happening. And I remember going to the studio, and we'd never spoken or talked before then, had we, John? I think we were just going into the studio, and I was so nervous. My knees were knocking. They didn't need any kind of percussion. I was doing all the percussion with my knees, okay? And I went to the studio, and I didn't know what to expect because he was so successful, this big legend in the industry, and here I was a new kid on the block. And I went in, and I want to tell you, he was so gentle, he was so sweet, and he was so kind to me, I couldn't help but fall in love all over again. And he did something that was fun. He was telling me how nervous he was, and I'm thinking to myself, you're nervous. I'm the kid with just with two projects out, and you're Mr. World, you know. And he broke out a bottle of wine, and we had a party in the studio with Mr. Jack Gold, who was producing the project at that time, and Jack was wonderful. So we drank a little wine, and then we went out and we started to sing, and it was just like I was a teenager all over again, in my living room in Gary, Indiana, standing in front of that television, singing along with Johnny Mathis. And I tell you, I've never worked with someone who is more greater than he. You know, I did start with Stevie Wonder, who taught me creativity. I then went to work with Earth, Wind, and Fire and Maurice White, who taught me the business of music. But Johnny taught me how to be great through humility. I've never met someone that is so humble as he is and have had the world in his hand, but yet as humble and gentle and as loving as he. And that's what I took from him and all the fun times that we had with each other. And he will have my heart forever. And it is a pleasure and an honor to be here with you today. I wouldn't prefer to be anywhere else. Anytime I jump in my car and drive from Las Vegas to sit up here with you, you know you have my heart. I love him. Mr. Johnny Mathis, please.
Thanks for joining us. You know, I can already feel the excitement building for our next Hollywood Media Professional Celebrity Showcase.